everyone. I hope all of you are very much safe in your home and following our online classes. So today we will start for class 10 biology, that is heredity and common genetic diseases. In my last video I have explained you the genetic crosses for hemophilia, but one last cross is remaining from hemophilia, and then we will move on to the topic of color blindness and then genetic counseling and the crosses for color blindness. So let's get started with the remaining part of the hemophilia. So let's get started. Over here I am doing the cross by taking the hemophilic father and normal mother. Hemophilic father means the father is totally affected with the hemophilic or the X-linked disease. So what will be the genotype of the father? That is XY is the normal genotype, but as he is hemophilic, that will be XHY. And normal mother means she is not affected, that means she is okay. So we will write the normal genotype XX. So this is our P generation, or we can say parental generation. Understood? Now this thing, they will produce the gametes, most obvious. So from the father we are getting XH and Y. From mother we are getting X and X. So these are the gametes. Understood? Now we will do the checkerboard. That means in order to find out the probability. So over here we are taking the mother, that means X, X, and father is XHY. So similarly we will do it. XHX, will multiply this XH with both of them. That means XHX, this one with this one, that means XHX. And again we will multiply this Y with this two, that means XY, and with this one and this one, means XY. Understood? So till this much we are done. Now what are the probabilities? XHX means carrier daughter. Over here XHX means also carrier daughter. So there is a 50% chance of having carrier daughter. Understood? And XY and XY, that means the sons are not affected. That means there is a 50% chance of getting a normal son. Understood? So this is the general cross. If the hemophilic father will marry a normal mother, then there is a chance that if they will have a daughter, then that daughter will definitely be carrier. But if they will have a son, that son will be totally normal. Understood? So till this much we are done with the hemophilia total concept, the total genetic cross of the hemophilia. Now next we will move on to the color blindness. We will move on to the topic of color blindness, which is also X-linked. That means it is a genetic disease which is obviously affecting the X chromosome. Okay. Now this color blindness was first observed by John Dalton. Okay. Now what happens in case of color blindness? In case of color blindness, the patient or the affected person cannot distinguish the red and the green color. Okay. Due to the mutation in some gene, what happens? The affected person cannot distinguish the green and the red color. Okay. Sometimes they also cannot distinguish the blue color due to the lack of some pigments. Now this red and green color blindness is also termed as Daltonism. Why? Because John Dalton was the first who invented or who experimented out this disease. Understood? Now what is the general cause for these color blindness? What happens? The X chromosome, the recessive gene, which is responsible for this differentiating the colors, this gene is actually present in the X chromosome. Now what happens, during mutation this gene gets mutated and the disease is actually taking place. So mutation in the X chromosome leads to the development of the color blindness. Now the gene, the mutant gene which is responsible for red color blindness, that mutant gene is termed as proton, PROTAN. Okay, proton is responsible for red color blindness, and the gene which is responsible for green color blindness, that is termed as deutan, DEUTAN. Okay, so proton and deutan are the two mutant genes responsible for red and green color blindness respectively. Now we will go, or we will view the symptoms of the color blindness. So let's get started. So we are dealing with the symptoms. Color blindness obviously is an X-linked recessive gene. It is being inherited. Now what happens, we have next point is the cone cells. Actually, in the first chapter of the class 10 we have read about cone cells, rod cells, right, in parts of eye. So the cone cells of eye in this person fail to distinguish the red and the green color. Understood? Number 3, besides the problem of color vision, this color blind person will have otherwise normal vision for reading, writing. That means they will not suffer any kind of other vision related problems. Only they cannot identify the color of red and green. Number 4 is the color blindness is more common in males than in females, because males have one X and other Y sex chromosome, whereas in human female there are two X chromosomes. Similarly, as I have told you, in case of hemophilic, what happens in case of female, females are having what? Double X setup. Males are having what? X and Y. Now we know that it is an X-linked disease. So if it is being affected in case of female, we are representing color blindness as C. Okay. So if it is affecting one chromosome, one X chromosome in case of female, that means only one X chromosome is affected. There is another extra X chromosome which can still play the role. Okay, so that is why it is termed as the carrier, just in case of hemophilia. But males are having only one X chromosome. Now if it is being affected, so there is no extra X chromosome that can replace or that can carry out some normal functions on behalf of this. So that is why males are color blind. They cannot be carrier, and the number of color blind in case of male is more than the female due to the one X chromosome, and we are having two X chromosome. Understood? So this was the thing of color blindness. Okay, so next we will go on to understand the cross for color blindness, just like we did in case of hemophilia. So let's see. So the cross is taking the normal father and the carrier mother. So normal father means the genetic composition will be normal, that means XY, it is not affected, is being crossed with the carrier mother. That means normally the composition of the mother is XX, but as it is carrier, that means only one X will be affected, that means XCX. Got it, everyone? Now this is the P generation. Understood? Now these parents will actually form the gametes over here, X, Y, and over here X, C and X. So these are the gametes. Understood? Now we'll do the checkerboard to get the probabilities of the offsprings. Over here we will keep the mother, and over here we'll keep the father. Now the gametes from the mother is XC and X, and gamete from the father is XY. Now this X will be multiplied with both of them, that means XCX and X into X. Got it? Similarly, this Y will be multiplied with both of them, that means X CY and XY. Got it till this much? Now, what are the percentage or what are the probabilities of getting the offspring? See, 25% of having carrier daughter. Got it? 25% of having a normal daughter. Colorblind son. Why colorblind? Because there is only one X and it is already affected, so it will be colorblind. No carrier. Males cannot be carrier as they are having only one X chromosome. So, one colorblind son. And 25% of having a normal son. So these are the probabilities if a normal father is getting married to the carrier woman. 25% they can have a carrier daughter, 25% normal daughter, 25% colorblind son, and 25% normal son. So this was till today. And in my next video, I will go on with the further crosses, genetic crosses of colorblindness and genetic counseling. So till then, you take care.